Hello. Hi, Neha, how are you? Hi, Neeti, how are you? Hi, Priyanka. Thank you so much, Neha. Hi, Revati. Hi, Archana. Hi, Prachi. Hi, Gul Kamal, is it? Whoever is here, please say hello so I know you are here. Hello, hello. Hi, Tithi. I'm good. Tithi, how are you? Hi, Nisa. Hi, Bhavishya. Hello. Is that Urodu? Hi, Simran. That's okay, Nisa. You finish work in half an hour. It's okay. And you've seen the last one, so you should be fine. Is the music too loud? Or is it okay? Hi, Akansha. Hi, Momodu. I didn't know that you had this name on Facebook. It's so nice to see you. Oh, that's a surprise. I'm glad you made it. How is everyone doing with the news of the lockdown extended for a week? Let's wait for another 5 minutes and see if anyone else is joining in. Hi, Bijul. How are you? It ruined your endless lockdowns. Yes. I'm good, Akanksha. How are you? I know, endless lockdowns. That's why we are here together to do something so we don't feel like we are in a lockdown. This is a nice way, isn't it, to get connected. I have people from India also connected here. I have Akanksha here from India. I have Bijul here from Ahmedabad, right? If I'm correct, Bijul. it's nice to be connected here. But that's okay. We should get this through as well. Another, just one more week, guys. Just one more week. Hi, Jay. How are you? Hi, Pooja. Shall we start or wait for another 2-3 minutes for everyone to come in? I'll get ready meanwhile. So I'm using... I think we should start, isn't it? I think we have enough people here now who want to do this, so let's not waste any time. Shall we? What just happened? Sorry, people. Hello, Nancy. Hi, Pooja. Sorry, guys, something happened to my laptop. That's okay if it doesn't work, so we can't do anything if it doesn't share, but let's get started. I think we have enough people, so I'll just... Hi, Shwetal. So I think I'll just get started because a lot of people are here. We don't want to waste anyone else's time. Sorry guys, something is wrong with my laptop and it continuously keeps shutting off. I guess I need to change the battery of my laptop. So sorry guys. While I'm turning my laptop again, I'll quickly show the materials that I'm going to use. Or actually, I'll start by showing a few things that I wanted to share last time as well, but I couldn't. So, I know I have a lot of people here who are doing it for the first time, so, and so I just wanted to show you how I started doing the mandalas. I'm sorry, I cannot read any comments right now until my laptop is turned on because I have set up the camera on the stand. So I can only see it once my laptop is turned on again. So just bear with me if you have any questions posted. Just give me 1 minute and I'll answer all your questions. So I'll show you how I started doing the mandalas. This is legit the first mandala I did with my hands. You can call it doodling. I wouldn't exactly call it a mandala, but yeah, that's how I started it. And the second mandala I did after that was probably this one. Literally. There is no measurements, nothing. I was just sitting down on the couch one day and I was just scribbling down on the new notebooks that I ordered from Doodle Dabba. And I just started doing these, and then I think the second one. Then I started using the measurements. This is how it looked like. And I ruined it here by dropping water. So you have to actually, with the black and white, you have to be very careful with what pens you're using as well, because you have to it's better to use waterproof ink pens. If you use the normal sketch pens or anything else, they are not waterproof. If you drop something, it will ruin it, literally, like this. You can't fix this thing. So these are the few things that I wanted to show. And today I decided that, and this is also mandala on top of, this is by Khushbu. This mandala is by Khushbu. So, yeah. And just give me 1 second so I open Facebook here. All right, now I'm using a black paper today. This is probably 200 GSM thick. And the materials, we are going to be doing a colored mandala. So I won't be explaining what we did in the last session because I already asked people to actually have a look at it. So basically, I asked everyone to be ready with this because I literally can do it in 5 minutes, but I won't be explaining exactly what I was doing last time because that took us like 40 minutes. So I just want to save those 40 minutes today. So you can use black paper. You can use a white paper. You can also use this is a craft paper, and this is also more than 200 GSM thick, so you can do something like this. So you can use black and white both on this paper, and you can use colored pens as well, or you can use these fine liners, which or texters as well, or sketch pens as they call in India. Over here it's called texters, and these are fine liner pens, so you can use these. I'll show everyone quickly. You can use these as well. They have a very fine tip and they are in many colors, so you can choose neon colors, or you can choose pastel shades, or you can just use any color you want. So see how thin they are. You can see. Can everyone see? Now, I won't be using these, but the best, I won't be using them on black paper. If I have to use these, I would use the white paper. And I'm not sure if they are waterproof, but since they are fine liners, Staedtler fine liner pens are normally waterproof. No, it doesn't say anything about being waterproof or anything. So, yeah. Now, I have these pens. I sometimes change. So, these are jelly rolls. They are of the name of the brand is Sakura. You can get it on Amazon. I'm not sure if you can get it in any shops here, but I had to get it from India. These ones you can get here in Australia, and they do exactly the same thing, much more similar, the same thing. So they both have the similar feeling. So that's how they look. And they are very fine line pens. Now these are jelly rolls. Jelly rolls have a little bit of a different tip than these ones. They are much more thinner. See? Even if I use the whites are different. When they dry out, they look different. A little bit different. But normally they would give you the same effect. This is the jelly roll that I've used. And this is the normal Uniball Signal pen. These are the ones I usually prefer for colored mandalas, which you can do on top of a black sheet. I will show you a few of the examples. So here it is, one of them. This is black, golden and silver that I've used. You can use this as well, but I use the same brand, golden and silver of Uniball. That's what I used for this one. And this is again black and white, which you can do on the black paper, or you can do something like this, which is other way around, a black pen and a white paper. And you can also do something like this if you want to do colored. So you can use a white paper, color it, and I think I have one more which I can show here. You can use watercolor, color the background whatever way you want, and then you can use the pens on top of it as well. So I've used black here and I've used white here. And then these are just the normal jelly rolls, mandalas. So you can just play with, either you can pick two colors, or I've only picked two colors. I'm pretty sure I only have two colors here, or three maybe, max. I have used almost all the colors here, and then over here as well, I've only used three colors. So, and you can do mandalas like this as well, guys. Literally, you can, if we draw the circles, and instead of doing all of them in circles, we can just draw something around whatever shape we want to make it in, be it a map, be it a figure of something, or anything we want to do. We can just, we basically do this part, and we can just draw whatever figure we want around it, and then just rub it off, and then start doing the mandalas inside it. So over here I have like multiple mandalas in one paper, if you can see. And over here I've just used white and green, that's it, only two colors. And over here, this one was I was inspired by peacock. Actually, I had a peacock feather and I just wanted to make it look like peacock, so I have the feather with me. So see, I used these colors. I wanted to give this effect. Do you see? So you can pick anything you want to get inspired with and just pick the colors, start doing whatever you want to do with it. Go with the flow, as I said before as well in the last session. There is no right or wrong in a mandala. You can do whatever way you want it to do. Now, I might not use jelly rolls today. And with these pens, you always need to have an extra paper on the side to scribble out. I'll show you why. Is everyone clear about the material so far? Thank you, Nisa. Okay, now I'm just gonna start quickly. I hope, has everyone seen the last session? I asked everyone to see the 40 minutes of the last session I did, the first 40 minutes. Is everyone clear about what I'm telling so far? About the base with the pencil that we have to draw? Alright, I might not explain quickly, but I'll show you guys quickly. So you have to figure out on your own what I'm doing. Now, if anyone has any questions about mandalas or they want to know anything about mandalas, keep asking me, guys. Keep talking as well. So I know you are here and I don't feel like I'm here alone. And I really want to hear from you guys, what you guys have been doing, how you guys have been doing, how lockdown has been treating everyone. I know it's been hard, especially for the parents. Also, I've decided one more thing, guys. I did the kids session on Sunday. So since the lockdown has been extended for another 1 week, I'll do one more session. I'll do another one on Sunday and I'll post the details by tonight, hopefully. For the kids, so yeah. Is everyone with me on Instagram? Sorry, I didn't. If whoever comes in, please say hello, give me a name so I know who is here so we can talk. Now that I'm from my laptop, I cannot see who is joining in. So please say hello, whoever is here. All right, I'm gonna pick one of my old mandalas today, and we're just gonna go through that one again because it takes time to figure out. I think I'll do this one since it might not take too long for us, and hopefully we'll get through this as soon as we can. Definitely, Ruchi. We are all in this together. So I'll definitely do one more session on Sunday. And we'll do it together. That's okay. I'll post the details soon, what we're going to do. And please, guys, whoever joins in on the lives, please make sure you click on going. Because so I know that whoever is... joining in, as sometimes I have to send particular materials to the people what we would be doing. So if I know who is coming in, if you're doing interested, I don't know if you're coming in or not. You have to click on going so I can send you the material, if there's any particular material I need to send you. And if you don't do going as well, if I make any changes or change the time or date, you won't be notified of any changes as well. If you do going, you would be notified automatically. Now, quickly. If someone doesn't understand anything what I'm doing, or you want me to go slow in something, please ask me questions if you have any. Now what I normally do here is, I've divided the page into four sections. So I've got my center point. I'm quickly giving you a recap what we did on that day. So now I normally, to keep it symmetrical, there's asymmetric and symmetric. So we are going symmetric here. It's a symmetric pattern. Asymmetric is anywhere. You draw anywhere, anything. There is no symmetry in it. So I usually take 1 centimeter, or in metrics basically, same. also please spare me for my playlist as well. I tend to listen to a lot of old songs as well. I'm just quickly going in circles. I've marked my spots. And whoever is doing the mandala with me, if you're just watching and you are going to try the mandala later, please share with me all your results. It would actually mean that I've actually taught you something. I was able to teach you something and you have actually grasped something. So please share your artwork later. It doesn't matter how it is, but please share it with me so I know how you did. And if there's any questions, you can definitely message me after that, or you can message me here as well. And I would love to hear a few stories as well here, guys. And I'm guessing we have a lot of mothers here today. Thank you, Navjot. Navjot, you must know a lot of these designs. You are a henna artist, aren't you? Thank you. No, you really don't have to worry about these pencil marks because these pencil marks will go eventually. Hi Shrey, how are you? Hi Iqbal. Now I'm done with my skeleton, you can say. So I'm just gonna use, alright, I'm gonna select the pens I'm gonna use. I might use white. I'm already done pink and I might just use the same three pens and this one. White, blue, light green, or you can say neon green and then dark green. And we're just gonna do the same design over again. And I need this paper on this side. So I have this handy. Light green. need this stick. Now I'm just gonna start in the middle by just drawing flower petals design. And now since I have the skeleton ready, it would be easy for me just to go over it. If you're using white paper, you can literally use any colors you want, but you can still draw the same design if you want to draw with me. What I am drawing, you are more than welcome to draw that, or if you want to do something different of your own, you can do that as well. And keep talking, guys. Whoever comes in, whoever joins in later as well, please say hello so I know you are here. Since I cannot see who is coming on the live session, please say hello. Now, does anyone know the history of mandalas? Anything about mandalas, whatever you know. Guys, am I audible? Audible, people? Now with the jelly rolls, you have to be careful. Make sure you're not using your hand over it, so do it from this end and just rotate the paper around instead, because if you don't, these are different pens, they need time to dry out, as they are most or you can say chalk like pens, liquid chalks they are, so you have to wait for them to dry out, or you just wait and then when it's dry out then you start doing it over it. Actually, lotuses are very good inspiration to start doing mandalas. Like, look at the lotus and use those lotus shapes to put it in your mandala designs. It would look gorgeous. Flowers are the really good example of how you can incorporate it in your mandalas, their shapes. Thank you, Vigil. Is everything clear so far to everyone? What I'm doing? I hope it is helping. Thank you. this is what happened in the middle. Bijal, did you get the details of the supplier that I gave you? I couldn't send you a text from my page, so I actually put it on the comments that we were having conversation on. Now, I'm trying to be really fast here today, but you have to be very patient when you're doing mandalas. So you can do it in your own share of time. Do it in installments if you can, because it can get really tiring for your arms and your hands, especially for your fingers. Mine sometimes hurt, like literally they are separated from my hands. That's how bad they hurt sometimes. So this is normal to experience when you're doing mandalas, but honestly, when you see your mandalas coming out, that pain is worth. Now, there is no right and wrong to which color where you want to choose, but I normally, what I try to do is do one layer of one color, then second, and then third with another color if I'm using three colors. Now, we are doing three circles here, so that's how the pattern I'm going to follow in this one. That's what we are doing today, but you can do anything you want. If you don't want to use this, you can use, this is one of the ways I do it, and this is literally the, I'm trying to save time here. So, and if you don't want to save time, you will get into more details of the mandalas, like this one. This is a very detailed mandala. It depends how many hours again you want to give in. And there's one more. This one. This is black and white again. And trust me guys, this one took me 14 hours and I did it in like 3 installments. I couldn't do it in one. It took me good 14 hours to do this one. Thank you, Shrey. Now, there's one more type of mandala actually that you can do in colored. It's not just pens. You can use paint colors as well. You can do it on a canvas as well. And if you know, rangolis are sort of mandalas only, and there are plenty of mandala designs that henna artists use as well. So that also you can do, not just this way. You can definitely use paint colors and paint brushes as well to do it. Now, when you're doing mandalas, there's one more thing. If you make a mistake, it's probably only you who can see the mistake. Nobody else can hardly figure out if you've done anything wrong in it. So don't worry about it. If you make a mistake, you can easily cover it up as well. Now I'm gonna do this flower pattern again. everyone with me so far? Now, I know this is a 2 hours class or a session, but mandalas normally take plenty of hours. So, if it was an A5 size paper, it would have been done. Or you can literally do any sort of doodle and then just draw mandala patterns in the middle, in between the shapes or whatever you're drawing as well. Hi Rupinder, thank you. almost done with my second circle. I'm just gonna wait for a few seconds for it to dry out.
I'm sorry, guys. Apparently, the video ended because of the background music we have and some copyright issues. And Instagram are weird. You cannot even have background music now. Apparently, everything is a copyright issue. Thank you so much, Neeti. Thank you so much. problem, Neeti. Great. Send me whenever you finish it. And I'm trying to finish it today. I have never been so quick in doing mandalas before. I normally do it very patiently. Hi guys, we are almost at the end. Almost. I hope I can finish it for you guys before 6:30. Trust me, I have never done a mandala so quick before. You don't have to do it at my pace, but as long as you're getting what I'm doing and you can do it in your own time, do that as well, because it can get really tiring as well doing a mandala. Is physically tiring, but mentally it is a stress buster activity that you should definitely do. It's just like journaling for me, sort of. People write diaries. I normally just sit and start doing mandalas. That's what, how it is used as a therapy for me. I use it as a therapy for me, myself. So you can definitely do it too. There are plenty of mandala artists that you can look up on. And basically these are just basic tricks to start doing something. My fingers hurt now. Now, do not try to rush in your mandalas. Please take your time to do it. Thank you, Reet. For some reason, the mandalas actually remind me of palaces of Rajasthan. Does anyone else feel the same? Rajasthani art is very similar to, I mean, they incorporate mandalas in a lot of their designs, or mandalas have a lot of those designs incorporated in them. Now To say it in a simple way, swastik can also be used as a mandala design to start off with. Even though it's in squared and not circle, a lot of historical mandalas, when they started, or in the other religions or cultures, if you want to call it, a lot of mandalas have squared shape as well. As you can, people, dots look really pretty in a mandala. They give a really good look to it. If you feel like you have space for a dot, put it. Don't even think about it again.
you see how you can just use 3 or 4 colors as well, or just use 2 colors and then bam, you have your mandala. In sync.
All right, people. I guess we come to an end of this session. I hope you guys enjoyed learning how to do mandalas. This was probably the last Facebook Live I've done for the lockdown. So if you really want to do any of these things again, you can just go back to any of the lives that happened in past and just refer to them. Okay? All right. Thank you so much, guys. I love you all. Bye.